animals, and maybe, maybe at some point know enough about how to reintroduce things so that that would be an option. What else could we have done? I don't know. I mean, we could have, like I mentioned, not brought African bullfrogs out of their native habitat in South Africa. And of course, not chop down any forests, but that's not realistic, is it?
So, do you miss how unfair it was before?
Well, I wasn't, so I've been in Monteverde since 1991, okay, so, there's been a lot of change since 1991, but, there was already some tourism here when I got here, so I can't compare with completely non-touristy Monteverde, all right, but I feel very strongly about this issue, I feel that you can complain about traffic and development and what we do with water, and all of those issues are real and they're things that we should think about and try to, reduce our impact in every way we can. Mm-hmm. But you need, if you think about, right, how you are going to enable humans and nature to coexist, you need a model, right, which enables both of those things. You can't just put everything in a reserve, right? Mm-hmm. So if we're going to compare the way things work here in this area with, let's say, a pineapple and banana landscape, where most people work for crap wages, and one big multinational company makes a ton of money, and no one has much independence or economic. Okay, but clearly, okay, not only many people are interested in that as a model for the world, okay? You want an urban environment, San Jose, let's say. Well, that doesn't function without, the forest around it, right? Because where does the water come from? Where does the electricity come from through that in Costa Rica, let's say? You want a cattle and rice environment, like, say, Guanacaste. So if you look at, the whole picture, right? Communities and nature coexisting, where people have options for work, and biodiversity has a place to exist. I would argue you cannot do it a lot better than this area. I mean, okay, there's lots of ways we can improve, right? But you have a 70,000 hectare chunk of forest. That's a lot of forest, okay? And right next to it, you have two major ecotourism centers. You have Monteverde on this side, and you have La Fortuna on the other side. The tourism that comes to these areas provides a living for thousands of families, right? And you don't have to be a nature guide, right? I mean, if you don't work in this area, if you're not working in, like coffee or dairy, you probably depend on tourism, right? Even if you're an electrician, working in a restaurant, if you're a mechanic, that's,